What's popping, guys? So I realize I don't go that much into like Astronomica strategy on the channel. I think the last video was like a year ago. My bad, been a little while. But with the upcoming tournament, I thought it would be a good idea to teach you, yes you, different ways to build a deck. Now if you're new, rules video is up here in the corner. But Astronomica is a game with a bit of an unconventional resource system. The open resource system allows for a lot of unique decks, but also a lot of confusion when it comes to deck building. Today's topic is very simple. I'm going to teach you three simple ways to start building your own Astronomica deck. Alright, way number one, resources. Now I know I just said it's a little bit different, yes, but building within a specific resource can make your deck more consistent because you'll have more planets you can play that card on. Something a new player might not realize though is a crossover between factions. Here's the graphic I use every time I can because I love it, but what it shows you is if you're running like a mono iron deck, a deck only using iron cards, you'd be able to run cards from Legion Corps or the Babylon Force that run iron. That's pretty big. Now your deck can run cards like Blazing Signet or Servant of War. Or let's say you're running a deck like Arlite Humans, but you're only looking inside Kakitos, looking into Legion Corps can give you access to great cards like Radiation Zone, a staple in the game. Let's move right on over into the second way to build a deck, staying within your faction. Now each faction does have a spread of three resources, and therefore it's more likely to find planets with those three resources mixed around on it. So staying within your faction can give you an easy way to build a deck, and a lot of cards require stuff within your faction or very specific resource combinations. Supply Drop, for example, is a powerful draw engine, but you have to be in Babylon. Having any non-Babylon planet makes it a blank card. Similarly, Atlas Church is one of the most powerful cards in the game, but it needs to hit a Legion Corps card for it to go off. If it doesn't, it's just a 5 attack beater. There are a few cards in the game that cost 3 resources and in response have powerful effects, so staying within your faction can give you access to some pretty unique cards. And now the final and probably most obvious way to build a deck is to look at the unit type. Most types have a bit of their own playstyle. Focusing on a type can lead to a less versatile but more powerful type of deck. Orcs focused on unit placement to get some extra effects, while drones swarm the field. Arlite humans deal with hand size, while fairies can bounce cards to the hand, and mechs trade power for being unable to move conventionally. A few cards, as of set 2, also have second types as well, and building along those can help you even specialize more of these type-based decks. For example, a drone deck with an emphasis on Saber gains a few more tricks, or a Kakitos deck that leans into Senators can do a few crazy combos with Overseer looking at and playing event cards, and then you play Selena to do it again. Now those were just a few ways to get started when building a deck, but there's a few unconventional ways to do it too. Let's start with the first deck that was on my channel. Runefire, which is a deck that uses two resources which do not share a planet, but at the time, it was one of the most powerful decks. Another unconventional deck, Six Resource Good Stuff, runs every resource in the deck and still works, better than you'd expect at least. You can also build along a specific card, for example. A fun one in set 2 is Cryogenic Chamber, which you can use to cheat out big monsters constantly. There's a lot of fun ways to build a deck, so you can take your time and look through the database, maybe figure out a cool strategy. Oh, but what database? Presenting the Astronomica Trading Card Game official website, a little bit under construction. Here you can check out a new tab with a filterable database by set, rarity, and card type. I hope you guys really enjoy this. You can check out every card you can pick up on the Game Crafter, and yeah, as always, I really hope this site makes checking out cards a little bit easier than what we had going on the Discord. Big shoutouts to the boy Leon SBU for the website. Now, advertisement aside, I hope this video gave you guys a few ideas to look into building your deck for the upcoming tournament. Did I mention there's a upcoming tournament? Because there is a upcoming tournament. And as always, subscribe to keep up and stay wavy.